Hello children, in today's class we are going to learn about a kutti story, The Witty Sparrow. Let us see children.
Children, what is meant by witty? Witty means clever, that is clever sparrow, witty sparrow.
Once there lived a very clever sparrow in a forest. All the animals in the forest greeted her with respect because of her intelligence. But there was an elephant named Gulu. He never gives respect to her. Gulu always used to walk near the bush purposefully in order to frighten the sparrow, and it moved towards fast to the nest with a loud sound. One day, the sparrow laid 3 eggs in her nest. The nest was in the bush. The sparrow was very much worried that Gulu might crack the eggs.
Madam said to Gulu that if he repeats this tomorrow, she will tie him up with a strong rope so that he can't move at all. She warned to Gulu. Gulu laughed at her. What are you going to tie me up? We will see that soon. And he went. Gulu went from that place.
That day afternoon, as she felt thirsty, she went to the river bed to drink water. That time, a crocodile inside the river was stretching the area where she was drinking water. Stretching means extend one's body or part of one's body. The sparrow said, "Blocking me again?" She warned that the crocodile has done this twice this week. She said angrily that she does not want to drink this muddy water. Then she asked the crocodile to move on from that place.
The crocodile said, "What? Move on? No, I won't go anywhere. If you want, better you go anywhere else to drink water." The sparrow warned the crocodile that today she will leave, but tomorrow, if she finds in the same place, she will not leave, and she will tie up the crocodile with a strong rope. Then the sparrow went back to her nest and got a brilliant idea.
The next day morning, Gulu came striking towards the bush, and then Gulu asked the sparrow, "Are you not tying me up?" The sparrow said, "How dare you to ask me without any fear?" She said, "Just wait."
Then the sparrow took a strong creeper and tied the elephant on one side end. The sparrow said to the elephant to stay there without moving until she reaches the other end of the rope and pull. And she said that when she says pull, you have to pull with all your strength. Then we'll be able to see how much the elephant can move.
Then it went to the river bed to drink water. She again saw the crocodile blocking her way. The crocodile said that he will not move from that place. If you want, you drink the muddy water. The sparrow took the other end of the creeper and tied the crocodile. She said that yesterday itself I have warned you not to come in my way, but still you blocked me. So wait till I tie the other end of the creeper. When I say pull, you start to pull with full effort. Let me see, are you able to pull or not? The sparrow went to the center of the creeper and watched the elephant and the crocodile pulled from one and the other side at the same time. This continued for a day. Both the animals were tired. Then both of them apologized to the sparrow
that they won't come again and disturb her in the sparrow's way. So she untied the rope. Then Gulu ran into the forest, and at the same time the crocodile dived into the river. Soon the eggs hatched and Madam Sparrow lived happily with her three little babies. Now let us read the story, The Witty Sparrow. Once a very clever brown sparrow lived in a forest, had three eggs in her nest. The nest was in a bush. All the animals greeted her, Madam, with respect. Gulu, the young elephant, never did so. Thud, thud, Gulu walked fast, the bush purposefully. It rattled the nest. Madam was worried that Gulu might crack the eggs. If you do this tomorrow, I will tie you up with a strong rope and then you can't move at all. I warn you. Tie me up? Ha ha ha. We will see. That afternoon, she went to the river bank to drink water. A crocodile was stretching in the spot she was drinking water. Blocking me again? You have done it twice this week. Move on, I don't want to drink muddy water. Move on, did you say? I will stay put. You better go elsewhere to drink water. Little thing like you tying me up? Ha ha ha. Today I will let you be, but if I find you in the same place tomorrow, I will tie you up with a strong rope. The sparrow went back to her nest and got a brilliant idea. Next morning, Gulu came thumping towards the bush. Hey, are you not tying me up? How dare you? Aren't you afraid of me? Just wait. The sparrow took a strong creeper and tied the elephant on one end. Shh! Don't you dare to move. Stay here until I fly and reach the other end of the rope to pull you. When I say pull, pull with all your strength. Let us see if you can move an inch. It went to the river, saw the crocodile blocking its way. I will not move, just like yesterday. Drink the muddy water. Sparrow took the other end of the creeper and tied the crocodile. I warned you yesterday. Now stay still until I grab the other end. When I say pull, let's see if you are able to pull or not. Sparrow went to the center of the creeper. Pull. The elephant and the crocodile pulled each other at the same time. This went on all day. Both the animals were exhausted. Please let me go. I won't disturb you again. Untie me. I won't stand in your way. Good. I will remove the rope. Gulu ran into the forest and the crocodile dived into the river. Soon the eggs hatched. Madam Sparrow lived happily with her three little babies. Choose the best answer. First one, all the animals called the sparrow. Option A, queen. Option B, madam. Option C, princess. And the right answer is option B, madam. Next, number two, the brown sparrow laid dash eggs. Option A, 4. Option B, 6. Option C, 3. And the right answer is option C, 3. Number three, dash lies stretching in the river.
Option A, crocodile. Option B, snake. Option C, tortoise. And the right answer is option A, crocodile. Number 4, sparrow tied the elephant and the crocodile with a dash. Option A, rope. Option B, cloth. Option C, creeper. And the right answer is option C, creeper. Number 5, the sparrow solved the problem with her dash. Option A, cunningness. Option B, intelligence. Option C, braveness. And the answer is option B, intelligence. Number the pictures and in correct order of the story. Children, you have to number the pictures according to the order of the story. So, first one, the sparrow had 3 eggs in her nest. Next one, second one, the sparrow went back to her nest and got a brilliant idea. Next picture, number 3. Next morning, Gulu came thumping towards the bush. Next one, fourth picture. It went to the river, saw the crocodile blocking its way. Next picture, sparrow took the other end of the creeper and tied the crocodile. Next picture, please let me go, I won't disturb you again. So the order is 4, 3, 6, 5, 2, 1. Let us learn the describing words adverb. Children, what is meant by an adverb? An adverb is a word used to tell more about a verb, and it almost always answers the questions how, when, where, how often, and in what way. Children, words like slowly, loudly, angrily, happily, sadly, quietly are all adverbs. Adverbs usually end in ly, but not always. Let us see some other examples. Children, look at the first picture. He rides his bicycle carefully. Here, rides is verb. And how he rides his bicycle? He rides his bicycle carefully. So here, carefully is an adverb. It describes the verb. How he rides? He rides carefully. So here, carefully is an adverb. Look at the next picture. He rides his bicycle carelessly. Here, carelessly is an adverb. How he rides? He rides carelessly. So, carelessly and carefully are adverbs. Look at these examples. She walks slowly. Here, walks is a verb. How does she walk? She walks slowly. Slowly is an adverb. Look at the next picture. He joined the duty yesterday. Here, joined is a verb. When did he join his duty? Yesterday. So, yesterday is an adverb. Look at the next example. He looked everywhere. Here, looked is a verb. Where did he look? Everywhere. So, everywhere is an adverb. Look at the next picture. He ate biscuits twice a day. Here, ate is a verb. How often did he eat? Twice. How often? Twice. So, twice is an adverb. So, an adverb is a word
used to tell more about a verb and it almost always answers the questions how, when, where, how often, and in what way.
Choose the correct answer. Look at the first picture. How does the man react? Happily, sadly, angrily. And the right answer is angrily. Look at the next picture. How does the cat walk? Walks fast, walks beautifully, walks harshly. And the right answer is walks beautifully. Look at the next picture. How does she read? Reads sadly, reads joyfully, reads angrily. And the right answer is reads joyfully. Look at the next picture. How does he speak? Speaks silently, speaks rarely, speaks loudly. And the right answer is speaks loudly. Look at the next picture. How do they celebrate? Celebrate sadly, celebrate sorrowfully, celebrate cheerfully. And the right answer is celebrate cheerfully.
Circle and write the adverbs. Number one, he laughed merrily. Here the adverb is merrily. Number two, we will leave today. Here the adverb is today. Number three, suddenly the old man fainted. Here the verb is fainted and the adverb is suddenly. Number four, I am waiting here. Here the adverb is here. Number five, I drink coffee thrice. How often? Thrice. Here the adverb is thrice. Pick and write the adverbs to complete the sentences. Here, the given adverbs are loudly, beautifully, brilliantly, bravely, cunningly. Number one, my dog barks loudly. Number two, she won the game brilliantly. Number three, she colored the picture beautifully. Number four, the lion fought bravely. Number five, a jackal cheated the crow cunningly.